Oh crap! So, the first like 10 issues.
Yeah.
It's just like your average superhero comic. There's nothing different about it. It's just, you know, it's a good superhero comic. It's got some good writing and stuff.
Yeah.
And then that happens, and the rest of the comic series is just like that, and it's so good. But those characters that happens with weren't introduced until that comic, and their introduction was that.
Hmm. Wow. That's...
Yeah. And the way that the case, or the cover is, it's Invincible getting ready to fight, but you can see basically, like, the gloves or maybe the boots or something else from those other characters, and they're pushing him away, saying, stay back, kid, we got this. So you're like, oh, we're gonna meet those characters. And then you meet them, and yeah.
Well...
All I can say is, if you haven't watched Invincible, go watch it.
I'm currently watching Invincible with him.
Yeah, we're on the second-to-last episode, and when we watch it, you are watching the last episode, too.
Yeah, because apparently they go well together, I guess.
Oh, no.
We beat the circuit. One more circuit left, and then we've beaten the game.
It turns out I was playing the whole time.
I'm going to...
Kill me.
Do you want me to try and fight Donkey Kong?
We can do one attempt.
Because I have to get to him.
If we get to him, we can do, like, one attempt.
Because it's random whether or not he shows up.
Oh, really?
Yes.
What happened? Like,
because basically, after you've defended your title from everybody, Matt goes into Last Stand, where if he loses 3 matches, he retires.
Uh-huh.
And he takes random fights. So you just randomly fight characters.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What would you do if Mike Tyson showed up in that?
I would lose.
Would you be like, oh my god, what is that mouth? I don't like it anymore,
It's Aran Ryan.
He's creepy.
I love Aran Ryan.
I love him. He's got a rat tail.
Yeah.
He's actually getting in your face time. It wasn't behind you.
No, he did before. Oh wait, no, he didn't. You're right.
Yeah, he was behind you.
I forgot. Wow.
He's got a whole rat tail.
Oh yeah, he runs around and he screams behind you.
Yeah. Hey Chris, if you ever watch this, remember when you had a rat tail in elementary school?
Why are you coming at the man like that?
Because it was funny.
Look.
Why are there, like, bullets?
There's a rope. That's because he broke through them with his fingers.
I don't get it. What's the point of the rope?
We'll see. He's gonna kill us.
He's gonna choke us out. Oh, God. Nope, there is no way I would ever do this. Unless I was playing through the whole game by myself. Yeah, I don't want to even attempt this. He's... No.
Damn it.
I say while I'm actually the one playing and doing a pretty decent job.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. It's me. Everybody knows me as the truth-speaking one. You're the liar.
What do you... Okay. By the way, I don't know if you've noticed... Oh, check it out.
Oh, that's cool. Fucking cheater.
And he screams. Oh, check this out. Remember how he tried to hit us before?
Oh, that's why he did that?
Well, no, he was just trying to hit us before, but now he has that, so he swings it at us.
Oh, that's so cool.
Also, he gets about 7 every time.
Yeah.
And every time that he gets stunned, he's dead. It's 7 hits.
Oh. Because 7's lucky? And he's
because,
Irish?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm Irish. I love walking around with my clovers. I'm a lucky boy. My Irish accent isn't very good.
You're right.
Shut up. I'm going to punch you right in your face. That was Scottish.
Maybe you shouldn't do accents.
Maybe
yet.
I shouldn't. I tried to do an
accent. Check it out. If you hit him in the stomach, it's the other one.
Oh, that's really cool. I tried to do a Scottish accent. You're good. For my dwarven character in D&D.
Oh yeah!
And then I would start it, and then get really quiet, and then I'd stop making accents. My favorite characters that I've played in D&D are... It's a tie. It's a tie between Griffin, my warlock, and...
No!
No, you almost had him! It's a tie between Griffin and...
Did you hear what he said?
No.
My sister hits harder than you, Mac!
And then someone threw something at him.
Don't step at him.
Hey, Mac, did you eat something?
Yeah, you think you're funny, One of the things he says whenever you're down, whenever you're down, he gets over your body and goes like this, and like crouches over you and goes, we got cheeseburgers in them gloves, Mac.
Yep, I know that one.
I love him. He's easily my favorite. Look at him.
I don't remember what I was. What the heck? I wish it was Mario. I want to see. I want to see Aran.
Man,
Ryan.
He would have gone. I could have finished that in round one. Damn it. He looks like a fish in the top right.
He does.
Mac looks like a generic character that you get in, like, a monster in a game.
He looks like Default Man.
Default Sam.
Default Sam? Oh, we need to play Serious Sam.
What's that?
Basically, you know...
By the way, I'm ruining him right now.
I know you are. You're still at 2.5 minutes.
Okay, wait, so what's Serious Sam?
You know Duke Nukem?
Yes.
I believe it's in the style... It's like another style like that, but
like
it's
a Doom
very...
Style game?
Yes, it's very violent. That's
is
all
like,
I know about
it. Is
it
like a parody or?
I don't know. That's all I know about it.
Oh, okay.
And I know it's just like a really good game.
Did you want to play it on the channel or like?
Oh, I want to play it on the channel.
Okay.
I want to play Doom. I want to play Wolfenstein.
Which Doom? All of them?
Well, when it comes to Doom, I want to play the newer ones first. And then go and play the classic ones. Because I haven't played the classic ones, but I have played the newer ones.
I haven't. I'm not very good at them.
I've played the original.
His knockout animation, my favorite too. He just kind of like
he gets tangled
flicks up. Around like a little cockroach after you knock it out.
My favorite. I've played the classic Wolfenstein game.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I have not.
It's so good. You get to fight Hitler.
I know. That's all I know about it. I've never played any Wolfenstein games.
In the newer one, you fight Hitler. No, you don't fight him. You interview him.
Huh?
You give him an interview as you're pretending that you're a guy.
I might start losing now.
That's fine.
Like from this point on.
But you pretend to be a reporter from a certain place in the States, because you know what the story of Wolfenstein is,
no,
right?
No, I don't.
The Nazis won World War II.
Oh,
yeah,
fun.
So you're part of a rebellion in the U.S. As far as I know, I've never played the games besides the classic one. What?
Look.
I am looking.
He's on roids.
Ew. But, as the main character, you interview Hitler, and if you answer the questions wrong too many times, or ask the wrong questions too many times, he just shoots you in the face.
Wow.
It's so freaking funny.
Fuck.
And in, I believe, one of the newer Wolfensteins, there are Nazis on the moon.
I'm sorry. This fight's hard.
In real life, though, we know the Nazis went to Antarctica and entered the Hollow Earth.
By the way, for every hit I get on him, it gives me one more hit in my chain.
Oh, that's
so
cool.
I really don't want to get hit, because if I get hit, then, it ends that.
You summon a bitch! Oh, yeah, now it was 2. 3. I read a comic by Shen Comics or Alter or whatever you know him as. Blue Chair?
I don't know who that is.
Oh. I'll show you some of his art, you'll recognize it. But he did a comic where it was a parody of One Punch Man.
Oh.
And they were getting attacked by like this green guy, and then this guy shows up and he's got 10,000 punches on his chest. And it's like, oh my god, we're saved! It's 10,000 punch guy! And the other guy's like, what? He punches people 10,000 times? Yeah! Okay. No, you don't understand. Each punch is slightly more powerful than the last. And it shows him lightly punch the bad guy in the face, and he just looks at him and he goes, that was one.
Wow. That's stupid.
It's so dumb, but it's so good.
I hate this fight.
I can tell.
Sorry, everybody. There's not going to be much more content out of me. This is where I start getting actually focusing and bad at the game.
That's why I'm here, because I talk too much, especially when I'm feeling anxious. Am I feeling anxious right now?
Are you asking me how you feel?
Please tell me. I don't know. No,
I don't know how
I'm
to
fine.
Feel without you.
Without you, I am empty. I love you. I'm sorry.
Okay.
I won't touch you anymore.
Okay.
I'll let you
the call lawyer if you didn't stop.
You were gonna call
Saul.
I said you were gonna call Holly and she was gonna beat me up.
Oh, she would.
Maybe we should censor that name.
No.
She doesn't care?
I hope not.
Oh, we'll text her.
Yeah,
I'll text her.
It's gonna be a while before I put this up. Why are you gonna text my girlfriend?
Give me your number. I'll say, hey, do you care if I say your name in a YouTube video? She'll be like, who is this? And I'll be like, is it okay if I say your name in a YouTube video? And she'll be like, I guess? And I'll be like, okay, thanks, bye.
Okay. Please don't harass my girlfriend.
No, I'm not gonna do that. I told my cousin Simon that we were gonna invite over the girl that he was talking to for his birthday, and I was gonna lock him in the basement. I told him that. And he randomly texted her, and he said, hey, when you come over for my birthday, search for me in the basement. Oh. And she was like, what? And he's like, don't worry about it.
Simon sounds funny. I don't need Simon. No?
No, he's okay.
Okay.
Simon's pretty cool. When he comes down to visit next, I'll introduce you. You could have met him if you came to D&D earlier than the last session. He was at one of them for like 5 minutes, and then...
Oh, I used it! It counted as using a star.
Oh, stupid. Ew! What is that bump in his head? Oh, he's hiccuping. He's actually drunk.
Yeah, that's the point.
It's not soda
anymore.
Do you
know his original name?
No.
His original name was going to be Vodka Drunkinski, but they had to censor it.
Yeah. Okay. That makes sense. I don't like that bump on his head. It looks like he's about to grow a horn. It looks like, what's his name? Howie Mandel from Little Monsters.
I don't watch things.
Howie Mandel, do you know that name?
I know who that is.
Okay. Little Monsters is a movie about a boy who has a monster.
Little Monsters, Big Adventures.
A monster comes out of from underneath his bed.
Yeah.
And he traps it in his room because
he... Oogie Boogie Man?
No, it's Howie Mandel.
Howie Mandel?
He's a teenage monster.
Howie Mandel, get out from underneath children's beds, please.
He was a teenager monster. And the kid trapped him in his room to be like, look, there was a monster. To be like, look, there was a monster under my bed the whole time. But then the monster is like, let me back under before daytime because things happen. And then daytime shows up and the kid, or the monster, grows horns. And you actually see the horns grow out of his head. And, the whole movie is about this kid.
Oh no, get up, please!
This kid is played by Fred Savage, who was in the Wonder Years.
Okay. No, that isn't me.
He was also the kid in the beginning of The Princess Bride, if you saw that movie, didn't you? Okay. But, he makes friends with the monster. And, goes to the monster world with him and starts becoming a monster himself. But then the monsters don't like that. So they kidnap his brother. The movie is really dark. For a kid's movie.
Oh, please tell me I won. I'm sorry. I didn't want to win by decision, but there was no other way. Please. Okay.
Oh.
I didn't want to win by decision, but I didn't want to have to refight him after going that far, so I just kind of stalled. I don't know if you could tell
me in there. I couldn't tell that you were stalling.
That took a lot of energy to stall like that. That's why I was making so many stupid idiot chimp sounds.